Well, new at 6 tonight, as public transit use continues to lag behind ridership, most commuters still try to get around Charlotte behind the wheel of a car, and tens of thousands of drivers use one of the busiest bypasses to cut from one end of the city to the other. Chief Transportation Correspondent Hawker Vanguard is live along Billy Graham Parkway, one of the busiest bypasses here in the city. And Hawker, the road there is in the process of a major facelift.
Yeah, it's a very busy thoroughfare here, and some spots are so dark, as you can see right here behind me on the other side of that bridge, that we had to put this vest on. We got to make sure we're safe out here. Not the same for drivers behind the wheel. They're driving into darkness there. We found out tonight what the holdup is. It's a major conduit for commuters that helps thousands of drivers bypass the stop-and-go squeeze of traffic on Charlotte's west side.
Billy Graham Parkway has certainly grown with the city. Of course, it's our connector to the airport, to 77.
Billy Graham Parkway, formerly known as Route 4, has undergone many upgrades since the road was opened in the 70s. The latest improvements to install more than 300 lights came at a cost of $1.8 million. But one area is still dangerously dark.
There is a lighting design plan that goes in, but Billy Graham Parkway is a very old road. And so at the time, there probably were not design provisions for lighting. And so you're seeing a lot of retrofits on some of these very old roads that have grown with time.
Billy Graham Parkway isn't the only stretch of road in need of illumination. Chris Sundy says that traffic engineers like himself rely on light from headlights and other sources for safety of drivers. He says designers have to ask themselves one question.
What are you designing for? And so if you happen to be in, say, uptown Charlotte, you're going to design for pedestrians walking anywhere, and you want the road completely lit up enough to see a pedestrian, even if you didn't have headlights, right? But on Billy Graham Parkway, you're expecting maybe less pedestrians and more of a high-speed vehicle who has their headlights working.
According to the Institute for Highway Safety, proper headlight performance means fewer crashes. Still, the city says more than 50 wrecks have happened on Billy Graham since 2014, a number that should trend down as more streetlights go up.
We brought you this story in March when the last streetlights did go up, and at this point, all the poles and the LED lights are up. But what we're waiting on is Duke Energy to get with the city to finally put together the conduits that power all the lights. And according to the city, that's all supposed to be done by early 2022. So you should be looking forward to some bright roads ahead. Along Billy Graham Parkway, I'm Hawker Vanguard. Back to you.
Yeah, pretty dark there from Tivola to 77 right now for sure. Hawker, thank you.